Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team, and today we are going to be investigating a few different surface analysis tools and how they can help in the design process. To begin, I have isolated the top piece of this coffee machine's casing, and we will begin by looking at the different highlight line tests we can run to analyze its surface. To do this, we can begin by clicking over to the Analysis tab and looking under the Face Shape group. This is where we will find all of the tests that we are going to perform. To start, I'm going to select Highlight Lines, which will pull up a window prompting us to select the faces that will be analyzed. For our purposes, I'm going to select all of this part's faces so we can see the overall impact of each test. Once our faces have been selected, we can see the different reflection lines across our part. This is a useful tool to analyze designs for surface imperfections and flaws. Next, we can explore the projection option. The projection tool projects lines directly onto the surface to help evaluate the geometric quality of the surface, consistency of shape, and any discontinuities. And last, we will look at the isoclines option. This tool produces curves that follow points on the surface whose face normals have the same angle to the selected reference vector. Now that we've reviewed the different highlight line options, I'm going to go back to the reflection option and save our analysis. You may also notice now our analysis test can be found in the Part Navigator under the Analysis section. I'm going to hide this test to avoid distraction during our next test. The next two tools I want to dive into are the radius and slope analysis tests. Here, we are able to produce a color gradient scale for both tests across the different faces within our part. The key for the different color values can be found on the right of the screen, which helps enormously in assessing your part during each test. Both of these tests can be integral to determining if your design is best fit for addressing consumer needs. Once finished, we once again can see the results for both tests have been organized in the Part Navigator in case we would like to go back and review the results at a later time. The last thing I want to explore is how we can best optimize these face analysis tests. If I go ahead and reopen the slope analysis window, we can see the data range option is set to automatic. If we change this to user defined, we can then control the number of colors, what value defines each color range, and the color itself. This is an excellent tool to personalize your analysis to fit your design constraints and criteria. In conclusion, in this video, we began by exploring the Highlight Lines tool. Here, we looked at reflections, projections, and isoclines. After this, we looked at a couple of face analysis tests, specifically the radius analysis and slope analysis. And finally, we finished by investigating how we could control and determine the color gradient scale for our tests. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.